when we join an organization, we don't join, when we start a career in an organization, we don't start a career as a on a leadership position. We always start our career at an entry level position. And there we become skilled over a period of time in handling a certain job. So we do that work, we become expert in that work. Then we have 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, and naturally we would like to have a promotion. We would like to have a raise. So to have a raise, the owner or the entrepreneur says, okay, if you want to have a raise, then you should be handling so and so position. So the raise comes with a position, or the position comes with a raise, either ways. But here the question is, when you interview somebody fresh and you have a sales manager's position ready, would you not ask that sales manager that are you capable of handling people? You would definitely ask, because that's a normal question. Bhai, aapne kahan team lead kari hai, aapne kisko handle kiya hai? Fir aap usko sales manager ki position dete ho. Ye hota hai jab aap hire karte ho from outside. But kya hota hai jab andar se aap kisi ko sales manager banate ho, you don't take his interview. You just put him on the sales manager position because you feel wo aapke sath 2 saal se 3 saal se hai aur abhi usko to kuch next level dena hai. And that's where majority of the mishirings happen. You have internal hiring and you put them on a position or a pedestal which they are not capable of supporting through their actions. So jab aisa hota hai jo karna padta, because what else the person will do if not to grow up in the organization, wo to hona hi hai. Uske sath ek zimmedari banti hai ek entrepreneur ki aur ek senior leader ki, ki wo unko hand hold kare, unko us kaam mein expert banaye, us kaam mein unki samajh ko build kare. To pehla kaam tha ki wo he was handling sales directly. So he was making calls, he was calling up people. Pehla kaam tha that he or she was handling operations, taking care of things there. Ab kaam kya ho gaya hai ki abhi sales ke saath saath sales team ko handle karna hai. Ab sales ke saath saath numbers ke upar kaam karna hai. Ab sales ke saath saath team ka motivation high karna hai. Sales ke saath saath team ke andar parivartan lane ki baatein karni hai. Sales ke saath saath team ke challenges ko, unke mood ko, swings ko, unke problems ko, unke challenges ko bhi handle karna hai. This all comes with leadership, which was not there when he or she was an individual salesperson. So yahan par entrepreneur ko ya to usko sikhana hai, ya usko seekhne ke liye bhejna chahiye kahin par leadership pe, ya usko handhold karke dheere dheere usko us kaam ki ek samajh lani chahiye. Aur yahan par entrepreneur chuk jata hai. He feels ki wo job karte karte wo seekh jayega. Seekh jayega, that is right. But uske khud ka seekhne mein ek cost hai. जब वो खुद सीखता है लोगों को हैंडल करना, लोगों को लीड करना, तो शायद उस चक्कर में काफ़ी लोग टूट जाते हैं उससे. और एक एंटरप्रेन्योर के लिए, एक ऑर्गेनाइजेशन के लिए ये बड़ा ही एक्सपेंसिव प्रपोजिशन होता है कि आप एक अच्छे आदमी को खोते हो क्योंकि उसके ऊपर का एक वीक लीडर होता है. तो एक हायरिंग में कितना जान जाती है, एक हायरिंग करके किसी को रिटेन करने में जान कितनी जाती है, रिटेन करने के बाद उसको परफॉर्म करने में कितनी जान जाती है, एक एंटरप्रेन्योर जानता है. और ऐसे में अगर आप एक वीक लीडर ले आते हो तो आपकी सारी मेहनत पे वो पानी फेर सकता है अनजाने में. ही इज ऑल्सो गॉट अ गुड हार्ट, ही इज ऑल्सो हीज गॉट अ गुड इंटेंट, लेकिन आउटकम नहीं हो रहा है बिकॉज उसको वो काम आता नहीं है, उससे कुछ मालूम नहीं कि लोगों को लीड कैसे करना है. सो एज अ एंटरप्रेन्योर यू हैव टू हैव लॉट ऑफ क्लैरिटी अबाउट आर माई लीडर्स केपेबल ऑफ और आर दे वंस वर्दी ऑफ ऑक्यूपाइंग दैट चेयर, इफ दे आर नॉट देन आई नीड टू ट्रेन देम. तो ये दैट्स वाई लीडरशिप ट्रेनिंग और लीडरशिप की क्लैरिटी देना बड़ा जरूरी है फॉर एंटरप्रेन्योर्स.